Hello and welcome everyone. So in this video, we are going to create a config service. This config service will provide a config data like host, port or DB configuration or any other kind of service which you are using which require runtime configuration, because we are not going to hard code these configurations in the code. We try to keep them in the .env and we have to read them from .env using either .env module or npm module. Here we have created a config service. So this config service will use .env module to read this and will inject this config service data to a database module, logger module, swagger module, wherever we need a configurations like Redis module. So I created this and let's import injectable from the config, and here we can have a private config and it will be a config data. Okay, here we will have a constructor. In this constructor, we will just pass the config data. Okay, and we are initializing this config data to the default config. Default config means whatever, like we have port, DB, log level, and all, and we have a local variable. So we'll initialize that with the config data. Okay, now we can just define our methods like load from .env. Here it will read the data from the process.env. So here we can override this config data information. This dot parse config from env. What we need to provide, the runtime argument. Okay, this method we have to write. It is accepting, returning a config data and taking a process.env as an argument. So what it is going to return, let's format this. Okay, so here we will just return all the arguments. Env, how we can get from the env dot. If you are able to get it from the env, otherwise it will be a default config. For config.env. So here we are saying that either get it from the .env or initialize it with the default values env.port. What is this? I have an issue with my keyboard, I think. Okay, and then if we are getting this code, then what we can do is parse it. env.port, and we can just provide otherwise we can just get it from the default config. Okay, similarly we have to do for the other arguments also, like we have a log level and database. So for database we need to capture the information separately. Okay, so here we have port, I think. Port we are getting from, okay, this method we have to define. Parse config from env, and this is the port, this is the database. Okay. And declare a method, this method we have declared, not like this. Okay, config db data we have to import from that interface. And now here we will return the db information. DB information is nothing but we will be returning an object of type config db data. That's it. So our most of the things are done. Why it is complaining? Okay, sorry. Yeah. So now this config service, we can create a config module also. What this config module.ts will have? A simple module declaration which we have like in the shared module. We can just copy this. In the config service, config.module.ts, we'll just provide the providers. We don't have imports here. So what do we have is, we will import the service from config service. So what we are exporting from here, export class config service. Config service we can inject in the export and in the provider. This is what we are exporting. And this is our config module. Okay, so in config module, now here is the catch. This is fine that we are initializing the module, importing, exporting and all. So here we have to pass a config factory. In the config service, we have to expose a method to provide a method to read the configuration from a config service. So here in the finally we will just have one method, which is a get method in the config service, which will give a way to get the data from a config data. So get method this dot config, that's it. This dot config is having all the information about the configuration. It is initially it is initialized with the default data. And later we are doing a load from environment. We are getting all the data from the process.env, initializing it. We are calling this parse config from env and we are getting all the config data here. And now we are injecting that data in our config module. So here our config module. In the config module now we can use one config factory. So here we have a config factory, config service. So this config service, we can't directly inject. What we want is, we wanted to first initialize the .env. We need to get some data from there. So what we can do is const config factory. And use factory. And here we can define, so here we will be loading the environment from the .env.config. And we can just import .env from .env module. We just need to import it. So here it will add the things in the process.env variable. Now we are creating the instance of config service. Okay, config service we are calling dot load from env and we are returning config. So this factory will be provided to all the other modules to get the data. Okay, and this data will be injected in the database module, Redis module, all the other variables to read the Redis information. Like I have a Redis. Initially it is undefined. Okay, I have okay, consider any other information like SES info, which is also undefined. But all these information I have to, it is a config data, right? So I have to specify same types here also, otherwise you will get an error. So similarly you can extend it and you can read the configuration through the config service. Now config service, this config module using this config factory will be exposing all the information out, and in the dependent modules we can read the configuration data.